And I'm back. And I gotta make a couple adjustments here. I'm gonna scroll down a bit. I can't remember what else I put up here. Oh, I'm trying to find another tag to put in my Twitch description. But still looking. I suppose I probably should have done this when I had my stream mode turned off. Finding anything. Randomizer. All right, I'll just do a single player. Okay, there we go. That. Get my controller turned on here. Oh, one other thing I need to look at. Okay. One of my viewers, Kataro. He left about three tables. He requested about three tables from me. So I'm gonna go ahead and start by doing those. And then after that, they're all gonna be random. This is actually one of my favorite tables right here. And the table's got a simple premise. Take down the drop targets. Got it. Just need to get that target on the lower right. And they all start over. Got it. In case you hadn't noticed, you don't want the ball going on the left side of the table. Oh, nice. Not so nice. And the second one he requested is Pinbot.
I am in your control.
And this table here is pretty much all about the left ramp. Skill shot and left ramp. And you want the ball out of the bumpers. Because otherwise that can happen. No. Due to the way this table works, whenever you hit that target that's underneath the ramp, you have to hit another target, otherwise that ramp cover won't drop. Okay, now locks are lit, or I should say the eyes are open. Another one. little underthrown there. Or I have to hit another target in order for the ramp to close. Because if the ball's up there in the ramp, that means it's not going out the right all lane. Something's lit in the upper left. Gotta aim for that hole. I'm thinking extra ball, but... And extra ball. That drains immediately afterwards, basically making it nothing more than a glorified ball save. And twice in a row. Buckle! In all caps. Having like no luck. Every time the ball goes up that ramp, it goes straight down to the bumpers. Oh, get up there. That's what... Okay, now that's a shitty play on my part. But that's why you keep the ball out of the bump... You don't want the ball in the bumpers. Because it'll often fly right to the left out lane. Get up there. Not in there. There we go. That's what I've been trying to do all along. And it goes down there anyway. hit another target in order for that ramp cover to close. Get up there. The ball didn't bounce the way I wanted it to. Oh. Sorry, Kataro. I tried. Okay, so... Indianapolis 500. Gotta look at something real quick. Right. The next table that Kataro has requested is Indianapolis 500. But, since I'm at a good stopping point right now, I'm gonna go get me something else to eat. But, and yes, I eat fairly often, but to be fair, I don't eat huge meals. Like, what I'm probably gonna grab now is just a peanut butter sandwich. So, I eat, my meals are small, but often. Usually every other hour. But anyway, I'll be back. Just like I said, gonna have a peanut butter sandwich and a Reese's peanut butter heart. We started carrying those recently, so bought me a bag of them. And yes, I'm a Reese's peanut butter junkie.
Go for the pole.
Go for the pole. Try not to suck.
There's a pin!
great day for racing and a great day for pinball. The yellow flag is out. The safety crews are
bad video mode. You'll hardly get much of a chance to see the obstacles. I think Akitaro deserves more than this. The whole set at the middle.
Driver two has a ball in the turbo, Bobby. Another one means a
guaranteed multi ball. If the shot's lit, I'm not gonna hit. Unless I do it like that. Nope.
Whoa, there's the second lock. We're ready for multi ball, and here we go. Either ramp is worth a jackpot.
Got it.
Extra ball.
For multi-ball, alternating the ramps gives you jackpot.
That's one.
Otherwise, I think you have to lock all the balls where the green arrows are. It doesn't help at all that the shot's on the right ramp, but then they put it on the right flipper.
One. Great shot. Hit anything. shot. Great move.
You hardly get a chance to react. Like I said, you hardly get a chance to react. My fault on that one. Shots lit, not gonna. Ooh, got it. Goddamn taxi ramp. Taxis got the same issue. Sometimes when the ball comes out of the ramp, it just goes charge it right on past the flipper. Apparently this table does it too.
Excellent shot. Super light up.
I was about to do it again.
The right ramp is worth a jackpot. That's one.
Oh, I got robbed. Sure, I get it in there now. It's not lit. No. No. Ball's supposed to go over here and down this hole and not flash straight out of there, down the middle. Another one means a guaranteed multi-ball. Shots lit, I'm not gonna hit. Sorry, Kataro. I tried. Alright, let's do some randoms.
Open Sesame.
The one that came with the game.
In ancient fact.
I am your genie.
The tale of Scheherazade.
Hit the yellow targets.
Camel race.
Great shot.
Try that again.
The locks are lit.
This is my last one.
Whose ball is locked?
The
wasn't even paying attention.
Go for the gold symbol. Amazing. Unleash the land's power.
Can't, it's lit. Whoa, got it. Butt sneeze. Okay.
The tale of Alibaba.
Alibaba and the 40 thieves. Alibaba and the 40 thieves. Second ball is locked.
Two is locked.
Or that one. Looks like he's got a nutsack on his chin. And again, the shot's lit, so I'm probably not gonna hit. Whoa. Hit that one on accident. Ball's lit. And it, extra ball is on the right loop.
Wow. new ball for you. I will help.
And the ball drains immediately after. Basically making that extra ball nothing more than a glorified ball save.
Shoot again.
Great shot.
Tale of the 40 Thieves.
Oh, wow. You just hit me. Alibaba and the 40 Thieves are actually separate. Of course I ain't gonna do that. Shot's lit. All right.
You possess the final inch.
Hurl the fireball. Time is running out. Shoot the golden symbols. Shoot the golden symbols.
I will never.
Basically, shoot the yellow targets. Right now, it's the ramp, right loop. Good luck on that.
Battle the skeleton.
I can't. The shots are lit.
Hurry.
Okay, yeah. You can also hit the genie at the back of the table as well. Yeah, especially with the way I'm shooting. Alright, now this one here. Until someone wins, but you gotta keep hitting yellow targets like crazy, and I'm about to sneeze. Hold on. Oh, excuse me. That was quick. I've seen things go worse.
You've made me so happy. You're my hero.
The Tale of the 40 Thieves.
Just keep hitting the left ramp.
Wonderful.
Of course, when the shot's being lit, I'm not gonna hit. Yeah. There. Oh, I didn't even register. Since I've already rescued the princess once already, I'm always gonna take the right option now.
Ball one is locked.
Welcome to the bazaar.
That'll help. Shooting stars are the magnet saves.
Great camel race. Second ball is locked.
Strike the genie for a multi-ball. Great shot.
Multi-ball!
Just gotta keep hitting the genie.
Strike the genie for jackpot.
Out when I didn't want it. And yes, the high score is mine. Not so much for that.
The Tale of Alibaba.
Alibaba.
Shoot for the golden symbol. Go to the bazaar. Wonderful. Make a wish.
Extra balls lit.
Extra ball is lit.
go. Yes, the ball can drain down the middle after going in that loop. Call that junk. Yes. I got fuckled there. God.
My ruby is yours.
Alright, next one. Full table. But I am gonna have to set this to two player though. Oh! That was kinda glitchy, but I'll take it. Wow! And a super sensitive table as well. Wow. I got fucked out of all of them. If I can hit the center ramp consistently, I should be able to last on this table for a while. And yes, I do have the high score.
It's sunny drive time!
It's try not to fuck up time! Much. But the reason why you want to get the center ramp consistently, every time you do, the total bonus increases by one. If you can get it to 99, from there on after, each center ramp you get gives you 200,000 points. And the ramp bonus here, it carries over from ball to ball. So you only gotta increase it once. Extra ball's lit. Multi-ball, gotta hit the center ramp. Okay. But not gonna happen. Deceptively hard shot to hit. It's the hole to the right of the center ramp. Thank you. too early. Oh, sure, I get it now. When an extra ball ain't lit. Same as before, get the center ramp. Said, if you could see it, that flashing green arrow up there. I want my time back. Ball stuck. Oh, bullshit. Back to this again. Bullshit. Oh, I guess it, there it goes. Wham, 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 wham. Not even too much. Oh, just barely. Nope. Thank you. by me again.
They locked on with all the hits.
Don't know if specials count as extra balls on this table. I can't remember. It's still ball one. What? Asked me to do something right for a change. Too much. Oh, barely. It is a deceptively hard shot to hit. This is basically gotta be a million plus. Oh, I got fuckoed. Alright, 99 miles. Here on out, whenever you get that center ramp, it'll be an end of the world 200k bonus. Not to be. Oh, it's end of the road. I thought it was end of the world. And they don't count as extra balls. Ball two.
Nope. First ball is locked.
Not enough. Oh, perfect. What was I wrong about that? Thank you. said, it's all about that center ramp. That one. I always picture the girl's boobs jiggling whenever she says it. Million! Single file down the middle. Jackpot! Jackpot! Perfect. Okay, there's center ramp. Gotta mess that up too. And I got a feeling I might have beaten my high score too. Bitchin'. Score, and this is 44. I guess I can kind of explain to you how this works. See these flashing arrows? This game actually kind of works like Whirlwind. These flashing arrows that you have to hit correspond to this billboard here. Every time you hit a flashing one of these lights up. Whenever you completely light this up, then a lock is lit. When you lock two balls, multi-ball starts. You can hit the center ramp from the right flipper, but it's kind of tricky to do so. And I think, whenever you hit that right ramp, it spots a target. Man, I'm doing very good on this table. Again, that shelter shot is very hard to hit. Got it. Rob. There it was. Fucked hard there. barely. Damn, locked them both. Here we go with this again. I want my time back. Close to beating my high score. Back to this again. Kinda glad that's over. The ball kept getting stuck. I don't think I beat my high score though. Or I might have. I don't flood my initials. Nope, didn't beat it. I came pretty damn close though. Oh, very close. I think I will go ahead and, if I can remember to, and if I have time, I'll go ahead and, make a video of this, documenting this. I mean, technically I didn't beat my high score, but I'm gonna say close enough. Plus, considering all the shitty luck I've been having and all the other tables I've been playing, I need some for my trouble. Okay, probably gonna be my last table right here. After this, I'm gonna have to shut her down. Same reason as has been going on. I got a grocery shop. I got some things that the store I normally go to, they no longer carry what I need. So I have to go at this store over here, and they don't open until 6 a.m. And I like to get there early because just to do it. And besides, I still got a bunch of morning stuff I'd have to get taken care of anyway, so.
My hero.
Oh, this will be a short one.
And now, on with the show.
Just barely got in here.
Aw, come on.
Well, maybe.
Hawk us!
Enjoy the film.
Whip.
Jesus, it's like championship pub all over again. One more.
No one escaped the black hole.
Okay. After playing this table so many times, I can pretty much tell you how this works. One, you want to stay away from this lower play field until you at least get double scoring. And you do that by taking down the drop targets in order. The flashing orange arrow, that's what you hit first. Same thing with here. You take down, you do just that, take down a bank, you get double scoring down here. Take down both banks, it's triple scoring. Otherwise, if the ball is down here, you have to take down a bank or drop targets. Otherwise, if the ball drains here, it's going to drain out here. So.
Thank you.
No!
Well, gate's open. Right by me. I got an extra ball from somewhere. I'm not having any luck at all. I'm trying to get those last two targets on the left bank. There we go. Oh, nice. Of course, I'm gonna fuck it up afterwards. There's one. There it is. Alright, now we'll go down there. There we go. One time I actually wanted to go downstairs, it doesn't. It's like you keep hearing me say throughout the stream, if the shot is lit, I'm not gonna hit. Wanted. at once wasn't enough. I'm actually trying to aim for that hole on the far left. Got multi-ball. Fuckled there. Alright. So, all's enough. That's gonna do it for me. I'm gonna go ahead and shut her down. Like I said, I got some shopping I gotta do. I gotta get that taken care of. Plus, I gotta eat breakfast. Got a bunch of other morning stuff I gotta get taken care of. But aside from that, nope. That's a pretty decent pinball arcade session. It went better than Pinball FX3, that's for sure. But overall, it's just, I mean, other than nearly beating that one high score, the rest of it's just nothing to write home about, so I'll just go ahead and kill it here and hope for a better session next week. But aside from that, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And I should be on later on this evening, somewhere between 4 to 4:30 p.m., and that's U.S. Central Time, and I will be playing Final Fantasy XIV. But until then, bye now, everybody. See you all next time.